Good morning, everybody. Thank you. I would like to take this opportunity to share some of my course, which is blends my Chinese art educational background to American one. Also, I would like to show you through my work to see how I'm looking for my own voice in the art, especially because of my major in China. Actually, when I get my master's degree, say major in painting and drawing, but in traditional Chinese painting and drawing, mostly ink paintings. But when I come to US, of course, I went to school. Then I studied Western art, and I changed my interest into oil painting. But sometimes I think there are some connection, also lots of similarity, because the art is not only just express yourself or reflect what you're thinking, but sometimes artists may have some social or responsibility to your society. So that's my way. I mean, I'm trying to, you know, go through my whole process. First, okay, this is my drawing. Actually, like most artists here, we have the traditional, not traditional, I mean academic drawing training in China. So this probably I get it from there. But I show you here is a more gesture drawing, which I did, you know, in this country. Goodness, what's going on? Then this is my traditional Chinese ink painting. This is my self-portrait. And if you can read the inscription on the calligraphy on the top, is that to tell I have, you know, I struggled. I faced so many challenges. The first one, this painting I painted probably in 1989. The first year I came to US, I faced lots of challenges. First is cultural. And second, you know, China has a, you know, political chaos that time, you know, Tiananmen incident. And myself, I just a visiting scholar in University of Tennessee. At the same time, I taught there. And the big shock, not a cultural shock, but also political or personal, because my wife and my son get kept in China. I cannot join me. So this is just my self-portrait and I express what I have, that kind of frustration there. And yeah, in Chinese, 情绪不佳之状. Yeah, this is the studio work I did in China when I was in graduate school. It's the ink painting. I just saw Professor Zhu's oil painting. I really like it because we have, even though different way, but I like that textural, you know, that kind of quality. And of course, in ink painting, we use dry brushes. We use wet, you know, make that contrast like watercolor do. But, you know, I probably my personal flavor, I mean, my personal favorite. And this is another one I'm trying to combine some kind of calligraphy as a form, as a part of the composition. And I did something which nobody did before me, is that I use a big calligraphy combine little ones. I try to make some kind of contrast, you know, with a small light ink on the back. Use a little calligraphy and contrast the front one. Like most graduate students in China, we have a couple of times to do like a field trip. Actually, we call painting tour. So you have to go to the countryside or remote area to paint and to draw, to live even with the peasants or, you know, the workers in the mine sometimes. So I went to Yunnan province. I spent a couple of weeks there and did a couple of series, and also Hailan Island. And this is from that experience, that tour to Hailan Island. I think that's 1986. Which, you know, China has, in Chinese art history, I think that time is a historical time in China. one hand, you know, we know that a modern art movement in, you know, 80s, mid-80s, like 85, and at that time it's 86. And there is an article wrote by an art critic. He challenges the traditional Chinese painting they call, I think of the title is something about the China Chinese traditional art is like a reflect the old ideology. It should be reformed, and you have to, you know. So that's this art I trying to just do something, you know, different from the classwork, like a traditional stuff. And this one probably is the result of that thinking, and you know. Somebody, when I show this work in U.S., people say, hey, this is Chinese Picasso. Anyway, it's different from Picasso, but I think most of the Chinese artists open their mind that time and also open their eye to the outside of the world, and which is kind of interesting. So I blend lots of modern art, you know, elements with this traditional technique. So this is my ink painting. Of course, like everybody, I mostly focus on the figure paintings. So that's I did this pastel in class. Actually, I teach a couple of different drawing classes. One is a pastel drawing, so I have to do some demo. This is a demonstration in the class for student. And some oil figure painting. Actually, I like the way when I teach the figure painting, I like paint with students sometimes, and not just to demo, but I paint with them. And students, I think they benefit sometimes. Of course, I'll tell them, okay, this is my way. You have your own way sometimes. But at least for somebody have no clue, then they have some kind of tangible information, I mean, in class. They say, hey, how the artist, how the teacher dealing with the same problem they may deal. Yeah, this is another pastel drawing. This is a group portrait. My son is on the left, I think on this side, on the right side. He's, my goodness, he went back to China 1998 or sometime, and with his friends in China. He born there, but he left there like 5 years old. Then, my goodness, these kids has fun. So I shoot a picture. And that wall, actually, that's a very dirty and moldy, you know, some kind of, that's with this life like these kids, I think kind of interesting contrast and that texture. Yeah, this is the figure painting. I like paint something really, like reflect my life. This actually first year my wife and my son joined me in U.S. after separation about 3 years. So what kind of happiness we have that time. This painting definitely reflects my feel, you know. We went to beaches, of course. And this is a demonstration for the class in my painting drawing class, painting, oil painting class. And the first couple of painting I did in this country, my idea still a little bit, you know, traditional, like a social realism, right? You know, most, but anyway, it's not too political, but it's like to show my feel about this country is full of life, full of, you know, the sunny days or whatever, I mean, happiness. Went back China, I think in 1990s. So I went back to my hometown. We have this kind of sculpture in the temple, and I like it. But later I did this portrait, my self-portrait, of course. Like some of artists, sometimes we have to survive, we have to make some money. So this is my commercial stuff, unfortunately, you have to see. So like a landscape, I went to Europe and I did a this series of a European, you know, landscape in France, and this I think close to the where the Molai live, you know, that lotus, I think lily pond, that area, and I went to Venice. This is a very traditional, I think, trying to blend this classical and the impressionism together. It's too commercial, anyway. But this one, another one, it's a dream. What do we call here is like a hometown in the dream series. Actually, I paint to Zhou Zhuang. It's by Shanghai City, you know, the next to Shanghai, probably half hour you drive there. It's like a water town. And they call them the Venice of the East. And I did it, exaggerated the colors and make this kind of textural, like juice, Mr. Juice work, you know, that kind of textures make me very comfortable because I feel that texture not only show the image, but also reflect some kind of social or, you know, philosophical or some you know, profound stuff there. This is like a tea house, which I like that kind of Mondrian look, you know, kind of, And it is slow and landscape. Very commercial. Sorry, I have to move fast. How many minutes I have? Two more? Anyway, this is my newer one, more conceptual. Fortune cookie series. Fortune cookie, I think, kind of very interesting because it's the only American made. In China, we don't see fortune cookie, unfortunately. Americans think, okay, misconception here is that, hey, you guys from China, you must have fortune cookie in China. I said, no, we don't have there. Only thing in US, we see the, you know, fortune cookie. So it's a kind of mixed, you know, interesting icon about the Chinese American or what a, you know, the dilemma we have here. Like, you know, most Chinese come here, they are in the middle between the two cultures. And this is just like that. Not a real Chinese, not a real American, right? This is what I did. So this is more conceptual, but a very pop color, you know, pop art like. All right, this is my new Manilian series, which is still colorful, okay? I try to do a little bit more abstract. Yeah, like this is Eva, this is the Temptation. And this is the whole series of the myths of the new millennium series, about the love, about the war, the terror of the nuclear war and peace, and also the new life for the human race. So that's the four piece. It's a big piece. I have a solo in a couple of gallery in DC area and some school. And anyway, this is just my trying to establish something new. I mean, try to explore the new way. This is my probably later one. I did this in China last year. I have my sabbatical there. This is called Infinity. And I wore, I like this image itself because that's a very unusual and think it's sculptural. At the same time, you can have lots of room for imagination. Could be yin yang, could be the world, you know, could be a life form which is from bottom up, then circulation. There is no ending. And or relationship, you have to tie each other together, whatever, it's just a oneness. This is my Infinity series. This is my last one. It's what we call the Animal Instinct series, which I use this dog, very, very brutal fighting thing, and that reflect, of course, the human race, okay? They have to fight, they have to make love or make friends or whatever. They cannot, it's like a yin and a yang. They cannot, so this is, I'm trying to, you know, do something more conceptual. So this is a series I did last year, my sabbatical leave. I think quite productive. Thank you.